Hey there, buddy, this is Indium here, welcoming you back to another episode of Let's Play Legend of Zelda Wind Waker on this stormy night that is taking place in Windfall Island. The moon is a crescent moon, so, yeah, that means that there will be a ghost ship out somewhere in the Great Sea. I don't know which phase of the moon the ghost ship appears on the crescent moon in the Great Sea. I don't know exactly the exact location of that. Anyway, we docked in Windfall Island, and the King of Red Lions basically told us to go check out the pirate ship, but that's not actually where you have to go. Where you have to go is behind the bomb shop here, skimmy across the wall, or shimmy across the wall, however you want to say it, and get around the back here, and then we'll have to climb in through the back entrance. So, yeah, you can see the ship over there, but you won't be able to do anything over there until you come here, because the pirates are after bombs so that they can break open that wall on Outset Island, where apparently this Jabun creature has taken refuge because of Ganon has destroyed the Great Fish Isles, which is where he was originally. So I am recording this still with a bit of an earache. I'm not feeling 100% great right now. I am getting better progressively. It's just when I recorded Mario Sunshine the other day, I just could not finish that video because the pain was too intense. I just kind of stopped. This guy looks like Mickey Mouse, but with one ear bigger than the other. Look, don't be mad at us. It's not our fault that we absolutely gotta have bombs to get the treasure we're after. How about you just think of it as payback for the nasty little monopoly you've been running here, yeah? Dude, you're tying the poor man up. He can't say anything. You can't question a hostage while they're gagged. So I bet you're thinking it was foolhardy to ask pirates to pay such an outrageous price, huh? Yep, I bet you are. You know, Gonzo, I still can't get over that bit of fast talking you pulled to get that information out of the postman. Huh? Oh, yeah, that was smooth. I tell you, the minute I set my eyes on that link, I just knew he was hiding something back at Outset, yeah. So when I saw that postman, I just pretended like it was like I was all worried about the kid and stuff. And presto, he spills the beans. Good work, Gonzo, really, just top notch. It's funny though, I'm thinking this is maybe the first time you've shown such wit, such cunning. You know, with your cunning and Miss Tetra's smarts, if you two get married and had a kid, that kid would be the greatest pirate to ever sail the seas. Yep, the greatest. Now he's blushing, he's all flattered. You idiot, keep your mouth shut, yeah? Don't be so stupid. Miss Tetra, are you listening to this nitwit? Can't you dock him some pay or something? Quit goofing off, both of you. Yeah, take this seriously, man. Well, actually, never mind, don't. Just be as stupid as possible, so then you can screw up your plans and we can just make way with bombs and beat you to it. Keep your childish jokes to yourself and get those bombs back to the ship. The second you're done loading them up, we're setting sail for Outset Island. What? Miss, we have to leave immediately? But it's been so long since we were on shore. We need to fill our bellies with some good eating, yeah? How about we grub tonight and show off tomorrow morning instead? I mean, I'm fine either way, of course. Whatever you say is fine, miss, is what I mean to say. It's just that the boys were so excited to come to town, yeah, and I can't help but think it would be awful hard on them to leave so soon with our proper layover. So what say we set sail tomorrow, yeah? What do you say, miss? That treasure isn't going anywhere. Now, I wouldn't be so sure about that. You with me, right, boys? Who's for a night of fun? Well, these guys sure know how to party. You're all fools, do you know that? You saw the demolished island, you saw the senseless destruction. We have to hurry on to Outset, for the same thing could happen there. Huh? Not to be disrespectful, but by the sounds of things, you're worried more about that island than the treasure, miss. Don't be ridiculous. I want you to know the treasure. No, oh, no, we've been spotted. Our cover's been blown. She's found us. Damn it. Alright, fine. Have it your way. We can leave town tomorrow, you big babies. But we're setting sail at first light, so no sleeping in. Understood? Aye, aye, Captain Remedy. Now they're moving out. So, One of his glasses is cracked. How the hell is he gonna see out the left lens there? I don't know. Say there, brother, what was today's password again? Mako, are you serious? You forgot already? You're so useless. Today's password is Chumley, yeah? Remember? You know that Nico won't let you in if you don't say it exactly right, and he's real picky about it, so I'll say it once more. Today's password is Chumley, yeah? Chumley, yeah? So, yeah, that's the password we need to get into the ship. That's why you had to come here first, mainly, otherwise you won't be able to gain access into the ship anyway. So now we can move around freely. This poor guy's tied up still. I mean, all he was doing was selling bombs. He was probably having a nice day, you know, up until the point where the pirates came in and trashed everything. He's probably having a really good day, you know, business going smoothly, and then all of a sudden just kidnapped. And it looks like... I mean, why is one of his hairs, like, longer than the other? It's like Mickey Mouse ears, but one's just ginormous while the other one's really tiny. I don't know. Maybe his barber had, like, a bad day or something. He was, like, drunk, trying to cut his hair, and he cut one shorter than the other. Anyway, so now we have to make way to the pirate ship with the password that we have. I believe it's different on every file that you do, so every playthrough won't be Chumley. It'll be something different, because I remember... Well, I remember on my previous playthroughs, it wasn't that, and that wasn't the password. But, I mean, I might be mistaken. How do you treat a shark? So you have to type this exactly the way it was spelled. So capital letters and everything. If you don't put the capital in, it won't get accepted. So I just put C-H Chumley. And then you should gain access into the ship. Right, you may enter. But it's not something you'd have to write down. I mean, it's something that they said multiple times, so you could easily, you know, remember it in your brain, you know, in your memory. Just, and now we can enter the Tetra's bedroom here. But there's nothing really of any value here. There's just, you know, decoration and stuff. And there's a picture of me next to her bed. What the heck? She's got a picture of me next to her bed. That's kind of creepy. Well, kind of creepy and flattering at the same time, I guess. Alright, let's go down to the basement here and see. We have to do another one of these, trial things that we did at the beginning of the game, but they made it more harder this time. Oh, Link, my old swabby Link, so you're alive. All the other pirates said you got done in by that bird monster in the Forsaken Fortress, so I thought... Never mind what I thought, you're alive. Oh, I get it now, you came back because you missed me so much. Yeah, that's totally the reason why we're here. I had no idea you wanted to be my swabby so badly. I see. Well, after you left, I went back to being the bottom rung on the ladder, which is why I'm stuck here while everyone else is in town having fun and eating stuff. But I guess being so worshipped by my swabby ought to cheer me up. Alright, why don't we set you to your next test, huh? This one is harder than the last. Good luck, you'll need a swabby. You can see there are lanterns hanging throughout the room, right? Well, last time when you pressed the switch, platforms rose up for you to jump onto right here. Well, this time, there aren't any, which means you have to jump from one rope to the next rope. Pretty tough. Yeah, this one is actually kind of annoying, because you have to position yourself exactly the way, like, you have to align yourself with the next rope pretty much dead accurately. And that's not all. This time I've put a gate on this door, too. The switch opens the gate, but it will close if you don't get here before the time runs out. Run out of time, and you'll have to try it again, little swabby. Oh boy. Okay. Let's get this trial underway, then, shall we? The switch that opens the gate is in the same place as before, so go step on it. If you get all the way to this side before time runs out, I'll give you the bombs we got in town. Yeah, you heard me. Give it your best shot, swabby. Well, we definitely could be doing with them bombs. So it looks like he nabbed some from the bomb shop without them knowing, I guess. I don't know if they knew, but... because it didn't seem like... Well, it seemed like they got some stuff from the bomb shop, but they were taking it with them to the, to wherever they were going to eat, I guess, and I screwed up, I think. I jumped to the wrong platform. Restart that, because I don't think you're meant to land on the thing is to swing from one rope to the next rope until you get to the other side. Okay, let's do this. So, yeah, swing to this one right here. See what I mean? You have to align yourself dead accurately, and you have to press A at the right time to get yourself the best jump that you can get. I'm gonna slide myself down here a little bit, because I don't want to hit my head on the roof. Oh, they're moving along the... Yeah, they're moving along the roof here. Crap. Can I backflip into that? Do you think that would actually work? Nah, that's not gonna work. Shoot. Oh, wait, hang on. Damn, that recovery. I think we're gonna run out of time anyway. I think I'm gonna make this. So now I've gotta wait for that rope to come back. Yeah, we screwed up big time here. Okay, jump. And I missed it. Alright, you know what, I'm just gonna reset that. I think they give you more time on this one too than they did the first time, because they obviously knew that this one was gonna be a bit harder. And I guess they expected you to fall several times doing this. Alright, it doesn't seem like they all move along, like, the roof. Okay, that was perfect. The perfect jump. Right there. I don't know if I'm gonna make this, though. That's kind of far out. Let's see. Oh, yes! Damn, that was awesome. And that was awesome too. Okay, I think we've done it. We just need to turn ourselves around here. Maybe make ourselves a little bit higher. No. Hang on, I just need to get my positioning right. I think that might just do it. Maybe. We need the perfect swing here. We can't screw up on the last jump. And we did it! There we go! Brilliant. So now I deserve my bombs, right? What, you've got to be... You did it already? You're incredible. This isn't good. I've never even passed this test. How could he do it so quickly and make it look so easy? And if I give this to him, everyone will know for sure. I'll be so busted. Okay. You're the best swabby of all time, so I guess I'll just give you the bombs. Go on, take them. Just don't tell anyone, okay? I'm serious. Really serious, okay? Okay? Okay, comprende, I got it. You're not gonna get in trouble. You're not gonna get scolded for this. I promise. This is a secret between me and you. So there we go. We got ourselves the bombs now. Which means we can also use them on the boat, too. So you can use the cannon on the boat. As soon as you acquire the bombs, you can use bombs on the boat and use them out sea to fight monsters and stuff. Pull one out, then press A to throw it, or R to set it at your feet. Try out, it's a blast. Using bombs while on your boat gives you a mighty cannon. You can use it to fight off seagoing enemies. Set them to, X, Y, or Z. That's mighty courageous of you trying to steal treasure from our pirates. From pirates. I suppose I should be shocked, but I'm more amazed that you managed to survive after being tossed out of that tower. From the look on your face, I have to guess you haven't saved your sister yet, huh? You don't give things much thought, do you? You just rush in, never thinking how badly things could go for you. Well, just now, the only reason you got what you did was because we left a simple-minded little rat like Nico behind to look after things. No one else would have parted with our treasure so easily, I assure you. And just how do you intend to use those bombs anyway? Don't tell me you're going after Jabun's treasure too. Right now, Jabun is hiding in a cave at the back of the island you were born on. Well, we already knew that anyway. But the entrance is blocked by a giant stone doorway. You can't get in without breaking down the door. We're going to relax in town and eat our fill of whatever this town has to offer, but we'll be leaving for Outset first thing in the morning. If you manage to find Jabun tonight, then I guess you win. But if you take too long, we'll come sailing right by you tomorrow morning, and believe me, you didn't get all of our bombs. You better be quick, kid. Okay guys, I think that'll be it for this video. Zelda Wind Waker with our newfound bombs, we shall be setting sail from Outset Island, no, from Windfall Island to Outset Island, to break down the stone doorway and gain access into Jabun's little hideout that he has back on our home island. So anyway, guys, until then, this is Indium, and thanks for watching. Dig everybody soon in this video, and goodbye.